In this video, we are going to see a clinical case with different types of peripheral retinal degenerations that have occurred simultaneously. This is the clinical case of a 59-year-old male with peripheral retinal hole, lattice degeneration, snail track degeneration, local peripheral pigmentary retinal degeneration, white without pressure, and peripheral cystoid degeneration. Pointed by the arrow, we can see a peripheral retinal hole. Peripheral retinal tears are defined as isolated tears due to a defect in the sensory retina caused by traction of the vitreous after an acute posterior vitreous detachment. Its prevalence is 9-12% of the general population. Retinal tears or retinal holes are caused by atrophic changes in the neurosensory retina. They have a high risk of complications, such as rheumatogenous retinal detachment, that occurs in 3-18% of patients. Retinal tears with symptoms on presentation should be treated with prophylactic laser treatment, most commonly transpupillary retinopexy. Here we can see a lattice degeneration. Lattice degeneration is a retinal thinning with loss of neurosensory layer and vitreoretinal adhesion at margin of lesion. Is found in 6-8% of patients. Lattice degeneration is a retinal thinning with fibrosis and vitreous liquefaction over the lesion. In the typical form, we find well-delineated thinning with white cross lines. This is the form we present here. The atypical form is found adjacent to vessels, in radial pattern. We can find oval or linear pattern of lesions, maybe one lesion or multiple, may have yellow deposits, pigment, atrophic holes or retinal tears. There is risk of rheumatogenous retinal detachment due to vitreous traction or atrophic holes. Retinal detachment is found between 14-35% of cases. Prophylactic laser treatment is commonly recommended in patients with vitreous traction and retinal tears associated with flashes and floaters. Here we can see a snail track degeneration. It is defined as groups of glistening white dots, which have been compared to frost granules or salt. Snail track degeneration may be early stage of lattice degeneration. Prevalence. Found in 10% of general population, more commonly in myopic eyes with 40%. Is a retinal thinning with vitreous liquefaction above the lesion, associated with vitreoretinal traction. More often in superior quadrants, superior temporal and superior nasal quadrants. Histologically, this lesion consists in a degeneration of the neural elements of retina, leading to an atrophy of the tissues with lipid deposits in the internal retinal layers. complications may lead to retinal tears or retinal holes in up to 54% of patients. OCT findings show irregular retinal surface, vitreous destruction, and vitreoretinal adhesions with traction at the margins. Prophylactic laser treatment should be recommended in patients with vitreous traction or retinal tears associated with flashes and floaters. In this clinical case, the relationship of proximity and continuity of the lesions of lattice degeneration and snail track degeneration reinforces the theory that snail track degeneration would be an early stage of lattice degeneration. Here we can see a localized peripheral pigmentary degeneration. Pigmentary degeneration reflects chronicity. The pigmented appearance indicates the soft and chronic traction of the vitreous in the attachment. The constant vitreous traction ends up causing damage to the retinal pigment epithelium. This lesion can be found associated with different types of peripheral retinal degeneration. Here we can see a white without pressure area. White without pressure is a distinctive white appearance of the peripheral retina without indentation and without mechanical stimulus. It's found in up to 30% of normal eyes, often bilateral, more frequently diagnosed in younger patients, maybe associated with longer axial length. Is whiter than the normal retina and the choroidal markings are almost obscured. Found in post-equatorial region at the base of the vitreous and thorax serrata. Whiteness further accentuated with the scleral depression and margins are sharply demarcated from normal retina. Exact cause is unknown. One school of thought states it to be a manifestation of peripheral vitreous traction, while one believes it to be simple and abnormal reflex from a structurally normal vitreous retinal interface. Frequently causes confusion with subclinical retinal detachment and retinoschisis, but indentation clearly reveals that the retina is still opposed to the retinal pigmentary epithelium. No treatment necessary. There is a low risk of association with retinal detachment, so patients are examined every 1 or 2 years. Here we can see a microcystoid degeneration. Peripheral cystoid degeneration is defined as a multiple small intraretinal microcystoid cavities, most frequently seen in temporal peripheral retina. Characteristically, they are yellow tiny vesicles with blurred borders on gray background. Typical form occurs in adults, may be complicated by fusion of cysts, development of cavities in the outer plexiform layer, and flat senile retinoschisis. Reticular form occurs in 18% of adults, may be complicated by bullous retinoschisis with cavities found in the retinal nerve fiber layer. This form is almost always found posterior to typical peripheral cystoid degeneration and tends to follow the retinal vessels. Thank you so much for your attention.